Okay guys, now we will discuss question number 23 to 27. So these are some 5-6 questions are there. These questions are primarily related to economics of generation and load frequency control topic. So in this load frequency control topic, is there for some PSU exams and for some PSUs like AP Transco, it is not there, load frequency control topic. But still, this concept of load frequency control, that means finding out the final frequency of the system, will be reflected in parallel operation of synchronous machines. So this will be helpful if you study now only. So question number 23, let us see. There are two generators, it seems, 200 megawatt, 400 megawatts. They both are operating in parallel. Each of them are having their individual governor droop characteristic, 4%, 5%. No load frequency of the system is 50 Hertz. It is supplying, total system is supplying a load of 600 megawatts. What is the final system frequency? So when the system is unloaded, the system frequency is F0, that is equal to some 50 Hertz. Now final frequency is asking you, final frequency means what? F0 minus change in the frequency. Why change in the frequency will be there? Because there is some loading on the generators. And when loading on the generators is there, since both of the generators are in parallel, okay, the both generators will drop by the same amount. Okay, that means delta F1 will be equal to delta F2 of the second generator also. That means both generators when are at no load will be at the same frequency because they both are in parallel. And even after application of load, load may be divided according to some other factors, but final frequency again, final frequency of the both generators will be the same because this is the condition for parallel operation. So we will try to find out. So I already told you that regulation constant or speed regulation constant is given by delta F by delta P. So delta F1, delta P1 will be equal to delta F2, delta P2. Okay. Where delta 1 is delta F1, delta P1 corresponds to, let us say, the rated condition. So rated change in the frequency means what is given by this speed setting number, isn't it? Speed number, speed constant number, that is 4%. So 4% of 50 hertz means how much? So it will be 2 hertz, 0.02 hertz. So 0.02 divided by when this rate, when the change in load is rated load, that means 200. So 0 to 200 means 200 will be equal to delta F2. Delta F2 means after loading, how much is the change in the frequency by P2, how much load is this sharing. So let us say P2 is P1, I mean the first generator is sharing a P1 amount of load. Okay, P1 plus P2 will be equal to 600 megawatts. From this I will write P2 is equal to 600 minus P1, like this I am writing. So this is P1 only. So from this if I cancel out, then I will get delta F2 of the first generator will be equal to 0.01 times of P1. Next we will find out for the second generator. For the second generator also same relation will apply. So delta F1 by delta P2 will be equal to delta F2 by delta P2. Okay, P1, P2. So delta F1 is the rated change in the frequency. What is the rated change in the frequency? 5%, means how much? 5%, 0.025 it seems. That is divided by what is the rated change in the load? 400 megawatts is equal to what is the now required change in frequency divided by the now how much amount of load is shared? 600 minus P1. 600 minus P1. So if you do this, what you will get after solving this, you will get delta F of the second generator will be equal to 15 by 4 minus P1 by 160. P1 by 160. Now I told you the delta F1 will be equal to delta F2. The change in frequency will be same for the both machines. So upon solving this, I will get delta, I mean, I will get P1 value. I will get P1 value is equal to 230.76. If P1 is 230.76, what is the change in frequency? Change in frequency is equal to 0.01 times, that is 10% of it. So 10% of 230 is 2.3 Hertz is the change in the frequency. If 2.3 Hertz is the drop in the frequency or change in the frequency, final frequency will be 47.7 Hertz. A turbine generator is having regulation constant of 6% on the generator rating of 120 mega MVA 50 Hertz. So let us say power factor is 1, so it is 120 megawatt. How much it is? 120 megawatt. Now you say that frequency decreases by how much? 0.01 hertz. The increase in turbine output for a steady state, how much? Steady state operation. So again, come back to this relation, delta F1 by delta P1 will be equal to delta F2 by delta P2. So he is asking in the second case after loading, how much is the load increment or how much is the load change? So delta P2 will be equal to delta F2 into delta P1 by delta F1. So delta F2, that means change in the frequency is how much after loading? 0.01 Hertz is the change in the frequency divided by into delta P1. Delta P1 corresponds to rated load. How much is the rated load? 120. divided by the, what is the rated change in the frequency? 6%. So 6% of 50 hertz will be equal to 0.03. So this is once and this is thrice. So now the change in frequency is 0.01. delta P1 is the total load. What is the total load? 120 divided by delta F1. What is the rated change in frequency? 6%. So 6% of 50 is 3 hertz. Now upon solving this, you will get 0.4 as the change in load. So option B is the answer for the question. Now question number 25 says, he has given you the incremental fuel cost characteristics of two plants and he has given you the load sharing also. What is the load sharing? Load sharing P1 plus P2 is equal to how much? 100. So he has given that P1 plus P2 is equal to 100 and is given you the incremental cost of the first generator that will be equal, that was equal to 0.1 P1 plus 8 it seems, and is given the incremental cost of the second generator and that he said is equal to 0.15 times of P2 plus 3. So P1 plus P2 is the total load shared, that will be equal to P1 will be, that I can write P1 is equal to 100 minus P2. So for economic operation, incremental costs of the both generators must be equal. So if I equate both the equations, 0.1 P1 plus 8 is equal to 0.15 P2 plus 3. So I substitute P1 is equal to 100 minus P2. So that will be equal to 10 minus 0.1 P2 plus 8 is equal to 0.15 P2 plus 3. Upon solving this, I will get 0.25 P2 is equal to 15, isn't it? From this, P2 will be equal to 15 into 4, that is 60 megawatt. So if P2 is 60 megawatt, what will be P1 is equal to 40 megawatt. So that will be the answer for this question. So which option tallies? Option A. Option A tallies with the given answer. Now 26th question is given, two alternators are working in parallel and supplying some load of 80 megawatt it seems. Machine 1 rating and its speed regulation is given. He is asking you to find out what is the load sharing. Now you see, speed regulation is same. When speed regulation is same, then load will be shared in proportion to their capacity. So load shared by generator A will be equal to the total load. What is the total load? 80 megawatt into generator rating of A. What is the rating of generator A? 40 by total sum of all the generators. So 40 plus 60. So if you do this, you will get D is equal to 40 plus 60. So this is equal to 32 megawatts. Similarly, PB is 80 into 60 by 40 plus 60, that is 100. So upon solving this, you will get 48 megawatt as the load shared by the generator 2. Or option D is the answer. Now in this 27th question, he has given you the governor turbine characteristics of the two generators like this. He is asking you the system is a lossless frequency, total load is 800 megawatt, that means P1 plus P2 is equal to 800. He is asking you to find out what is the final frequency of the system, and the final frequency of the system is given in this expression only. Okay, and he is given you the expression for P1 and P2. Let us try to solve this question. So this question is given that P1 plus P2 is equal to how much total load? 800 megawatts. 800 megawatt is the total load. And is given you the expression for P1 and P2. What did he say P1 is equal to? He says that P1 is equal to 50 into 50 minus F itself. And he said P2 is equal to 100 into 51 minus F. Just substitute the value of P1 and P2 in this expression. Then you will get what? You will get 250 minus 5F plus 510 minus 10F is equal to 80. And after solving this, I will get F is equal to 45.33 hertz. So I will get the final frequency as 45.33 hertz for this question. What is the final frequency? Option C is the answer for this question. Thank you for watching.